Welcome to my first tutorial of Introduction to Statistics, Data and Distributions. Please remember that behind any data set, we have population, we have sample maybe from this population, set of variables, and for each variable's values, each value is for individuals or objects of the population. Then we organize this data set as distributions, frequency or relative frequency distributions. Population, you may think that population is all people, but it is all people or object that qualified for a particular study. Sometimes population is too big and we select part of the population, call it sample. We study the sample. And if the sample is representative, we make inferences about the population. Variable is any observable and measurable characteristics of individuals or object of our study. For example, the height of this model is a value of the variable height of all models that we study. Some characteristics are not measurable, such as beauty, intelligence, ability. So we have variables and we have combination of variables called constructs, such as intelligence and beauty. The values of the variable are measured in different scales: nominal, ordinal, interval, and ratio. So this is the most simple database in which I want to show you what is the convention between statisticians, how they record data. Let's say that I have my students, and here are some of my students, and I have the ID of my students, and then all variables are in separate columns. The first column, nominal type of data, variable 1, variable 2 is the name of variable, is 2, 3 and 4. And I will use 4 different type of levels of measurement for these variables. Now the first record is for one individual or object in the survey. I have the ID of my student Alberto and his grade is B. Interval type of data is his grade, his score as a percent, and his age is 20. Then I have Kenny, who has grade A, and finally this is Tam, and her grade is C. So this is how a database, simple database, looks like. So here I generated some scores of students, not my students, those are randomly generated scores. I have 29 scores total, and then I organize these scores from least to greatest. I would like to further organize my data the way teachers organize data. First, they jam all grades between 0 and 60 in one interval called F. But in this case, F means frequency. So I want to see how many students in this randomly generated data have a grade less than 60. And you can see they are 13 students. So 13 students is the frequency for the first interval. Let's see the second interval between 60 and 70. I have 2 5 students in this interval. I specifically selected easy to calculate data. In the third interval between 70 and 80, I have again 5, and I can see that there are only 2 students with grade between 80 and 90. This is grade B, very rare grade in my class. No, I'm joking. And finally, I have 4 students with A grade. So there are 4 students. Now I want to see how many are all this, the sum of all frequencies. and the sum of all frequencies is 29. One more distribution that I will consider today is relative frequency distribution. This is the frequency in each interval divided by the total number of cases, which in our case is 29. So I have the frequency in the first interval, which is 4 times or 5 times larger than all the others, maybe even 6 times larger, divided by the total number of cases. And please don't forget to put a dollar sign to keep this cell constant as we copy the formula. So let's copy the formula, and these are the relative frequencies in each interval. What is the sum of relative frequencies? The sum of relative frequencies always, always is 1.